Didn't see you there. I'm Dr. Radke, and today we will be discovering poliomyelitis.
Today, we have Habab Malik, a very brave young man suffering with this disease, and his mother, Fatimama, here to tell you about this deadly disease they've been living with. I must say, you are a very brave woman. Yes, thank you. Thank you a lot. Miss Fatimama, can you please tell us some symptoms that told you that Habab had poliomyelitis?
Yes, he had extreme fatigue, a lot of muscle weakness. He also had a lot of rashes that were very irritating.
I see. How do you think that Habab got this very terrible disease?
I'm not really sure. I think it was something from the water is what people told me.
Oh, the water. Is that like dirty water?
Yes. I had adopted him from Syria.
Oh, from Syria? Wow, yes. The water there is very bad.
Most cases of poliomyelitis are found in Syria and northern parts of Africa, as you can see.
Today, I will be doing a regular checkup on Habab. His mother, Fatimama, and him are on their way now.
Let's see, Habab. How are you doing today, Habab? Most cases of polio come from water in contaminated parts of Syria and Africa. Once this virus is inside, it can affect the spinal cord brain matter, which is very bad. Okay, let's get you into this bed.
Good.
Come on. 1, 2, 3. This affects the nerves connected to the spinal cord and disables some limbs. Come on, Habab, you gotta help. Okay, Habab, you silly Habab. Okay. A patient is fully diagnosed when there is a presence of cerebrospinal fluid.
Habab's muscles are very weak. He has no control over his limbs. Seeing a patient like this makes me wonder how hard it must be in their daily lives.
In some cases, it can fully or partially paralyze a patient.
In Habab's case, he is partially paralyzed and can be treated by a physical therapist.
I take him to a physical therapist twice a week, and I make sure he takes his medicine daily.
There are no ways to cure this disease, but we can make his life easier living with it. On top of the physical therapy, he also takes NSAIDs and antibiotics daily to relieve muscle pain and eliminate infections in the upper respiratory tract. Some activities that we do include breathing exercises.
He's been recovering, but still continues to fight poliomyelitis.
Spend all your time waiting for that second chance, for the break that will make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some. Let me be empty. Ooh.
What?